These past few weeks, we've been talking about exhibition, and we needed to have a main topic. So my group chose the topic tsunamis. Me and Kino chose the topic what can cause a tsunami, and Moira and Sayoung chose tsunami safety. Now Moira is going to talk about what a tsunami is.
A tsunami is a series of waves which can get 90 foot tall and faster than a jet plane. A tsunami is really dangerous where a lot of people get killed. Tsunami translated from Japanese to English is horrible. Now Sayoung is going to talk about where tsunamis happen.
So this is the Ring of Fire. It is at the Pacific Ocean edge sea, and this is where the most of the tsunamis happen because most of the water of the Earth is at the Pacific Ocean. Now Kano is going to talk about how earthquakes can cause tsunami.
An earthquake can cause a tsunami when the plates crash into each other. But for example, if the plates crash into each other and they don't make such a force, it's not going to make a tsunami. But if the plates crash into each other with such force that the continental plate goes up like a catapult, but you actually don't feel it, and then it starts making the series of huge waves, that is called a tsunami. Also, a landslide can cause a tsunami when coral or ice falls to the ground. They make this huge wave. As I said before, to make a tsunami, it needs to have lots of force. Also, earthquake can make the coral or things there in the sea to rumble and then fall down on the ground, and then that can cause a tsunami. And now Finn is going to talk about how can a meteorite and underwater volcano will cause a tsunami. Okay. Now, well, because over 70% of the world is covered in water, a meteorite has a much bigger chance of landing in the ocean than landing on the land. Now, a very small meteorite doesn't have a really big chance of forming a tsunami because of its mass. Because it's so small, when it crashes, it doesn't give enough force to make the force under the meteorite go up and form a tsunami. But when a really big meteorite crashes into the water, it's so strong, it gives so much speed, it goes down so fast, and the force under the meteorite will then go up and will go over the sea water calm level, which is at the top of the water, and that will then form a small wave by wave by wave, which will then form a massive tsunami. Now you can relate this to a pond. When you throw a small stone in the water, it won't give a big splash. When you throw a very big meteorite into the water, it will give a massive splash. Now I'm going to talk about how an underwater volcano can cause a tsunami. Now, as you can see here, this is an underwater volcano, and that's the magma. And when the magma is very strong, it gives lots of force and is very fast. It's so strong, it can sometimes break through the side of the volcano and go through. Now when it goes through, the gas it'll give will go really high and it'll go over the seawater column which is there, and when it goes above that, it will form a tsunami, like a meteorite will. But when the eruption isn't big enough, it won't be able to go above and it will go stay right there and won't form a tsunami. But that's what most of us hope for. Now a tsunami can go from an underwater volcano eruption can come from both sides or from the top. Now, Moira is going to talk about tsunami safety.
Animals somehow know before a tsunami happens, and they run to higher ground and act well. Animals that have been seen showing these reactions are elephants, birds, deer, wild boar, jackals, civets, tigers, etc. Some scientists say that animals have a sixth sense in which they use to hear or see when a tsunami comes. Other scientists say they have bigger ears and they can hear when a tsunami comes. In 2006 in India there was a tsunami. 10,000 people have been killed but not one animal. Scientists are figuring out how
a tsunami comes, and if we also can find out how that happens.
That's the young's going to talk about buildings.
First, the ground should be rough to stop the tsunami, and the building should be diagonal shaped to reduce the power of the wave, and the building should be about 1 meter above the ground so that the water can flow under. For example, timber buildings, they're good for earthquakes, but they're not that good for tsunamis because it's so light that it will just flow away and nothing can hold it down. Now Kino is going to talk about the action that we took.
As you can see, for our action, we have our group has this book that is going to be in the library soon. And you can check it out whenever you want. And these are some sources that we use. For research, we use Magic Treehouse, comics, etc. For example, Springer wasn't really a researching website, but it was more for keeping track of what you're doing. And EBSCO is also a research place to go. And these are some places